今天呢，我们非常感恩呢，请来一位老朋友为我们证道。
Today we're so glad to welcome an old friend back here in our church to preach for us once again.
都很熟悉的春宁弟兄。
We all know him, Brother Joseph.
春宁弟兄呢是五月份呢就会从神学院毕业。毕业以后呢，他就要去威斯康星那边的一个华人教会，一个长老会的教会，在那边牧养教会。
Brother Joseph will be graduating from seminary in May, and he will be going to a Chinese church in Madison, Wisconsin, and serve there.
所以我们很珍惜这个机会。他离开这边之前，我们能再有这个机会，请春宁弟兄来为我们证道。
So we cherish this opportunity that he can come once again to preach for us.
那 Jason 呢？春宁弟兄的儿子会为父亲来翻译。
I will be translating for him.
好，我们把这个时间交给春宁弟兄。
弟兄们平安。
Peace
is risen. 祝大家复活节快乐。
We hope everyone has a happy Easter.
今天我们也一起查考有关复活节的信息，在提摩太后书的二章八到十三节。
Today we'll look at the message about resurrection. It's in 2 Timothy 2:8-13.
提摩太后书呢是保罗晚年的作品，而且是在监狱里写作的。
Paul wrote the book of 2 Timothy in the latter years of his life, and it's written when he's in prison.
我想重点提一下保罗当时的处境。保罗实际上预知到自己将要离世，因为不久以后他就要在尼禄的手下被处决。
So I want to focus on the situation that Paul is in. Paul knew that the time of his departure is near, and he knows that soon he will be executed under Emperor Nero.
他在四章说，我现在被交奠，我离世的时候到了，那美好的仗我已经打过了，当跑的路已经跑尽了，所信的道我已经守住了。
He says that, for I'm already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time of my departure has come. I fought the good fight, I finished the race, I've kept the faith.
所以保罗当时的处境是审讯当前，他知道自己要被处决。
So the situation that Paul is in is that he will stand trial, and he knows that he's about to be put to death.
而保罗的朋友呢，也都四散离开他。
And all of Paul's friends either abandoned him or betrayed him.
四章说有一个叫迪马的，因为贪爱现今世界，就离弃保罗去了帖撒罗尼迦。
Chapter 4 talks about a person named Demas who is in love with the present world and has deserted Paul to go to Thessalonica.
保罗也提出自己其他经历的其他的恶待，他说凡在亚细亚的人都离弃我。
Paul also talks about the other unfair treatment he has received. He said that all who are in Asia turn away from me.
还有一个铜匠叫亚历山大也做了许多恶事来陷害保罗。
There's also a coppersmith named Alexander, he did great harm to Paul.
所以从保罗的处境在人看来呢是非常悲惨的。
So the Paul's surrounding from a worldly point of view is tragic.
但有意思的是，我们从这封信中呢，不仅看不到他的绝望和抱怨，反而能够读出一种极大的、坚定的喜乐来。
But what is interesting is that from his letter, we cannot find a single trace of hopelessness or complaint.But rather, we see the great joyfulness in Paul.
保罗不是在讲自己有多冤，说为主奔波一生，最后遭遇如此不公的待遇，还要被处死。
So Paul is not talking about the unfair treatment he has received, that he has dedicated his life to serving God, and in the end, he faced such injustice, and to the point that he's even going to be put to death.
他不是在讲这些，而是充满了一种坚定的喜乐和盼望。
He's not talking about this, but rather he's been filled with firm joy and hope.
而且他在知道自己将要离世的情况下，依然惦记教会的事情。
And knowing that he is going to leave this world soon, he is still concerned for the church.
所以他写信给提摩太说，要坚守，要持守这样一个纯正的福音。
So he wrote this letter to Timothy, asking him to maintain the truthfulness of the gospel.
一章一到十三节说，你从我听的那纯正话语的规模，要用在基督耶稣里的信心和爱心。常常守着。
Chapter 1, verse 13 says, follow the pattern of the sound words that you have heard from me in the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus.
所以我们今天读经的时候呢, 一是要特别留意保罗的话语中流露出的这种坚定的喜乐和盼望。
So when we read the passage today, pay attention to the hope and joy that's shown through Paul's word.
另外也要知道, 保罗嘱咐提摩太的, 实际上也是他嘱咐当时整个以弗所教会的, 也是给我们今天弟兄姐妹所讲的。
In addition, we also should know that Paul's reminder to Timothy is his reminder for the whole church in Ephesus, and it is also a reminder for us today.
我们一起来听神的话。
Let's hear God's word.
提摩太后书2章8到13节。
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 8 to 13.
你要纪念耶稣基督乃是大卫的后裔，他从死里复活，正合乎我所传的福音。我为这福音受苦难，甚至被捆绑，像犯人一样。然而神的道却不被捆绑，所以我为选民凡事忍耐，叫他们也可以得着那在基督耶稣里的救恩和永远的荣耀。有可信的话说，我们若与基督同死，也必与他同活；我们若能忍耐， 也必和他一同作王，我们若不认他，他也必不认我们。我们纵然失信，他仍是可信的，因为他不能背乎自己。这是神的话。Remember
Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel, for which I am suffering, bound with chains as a criminal. But the word of God is not bound. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, with eternal glory. The saying is trustworthy, for if we have died with him, we'll also live with him. If we endure, we'll also reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Let's pray.
主啊，我们感谢你, 是我们可以在一起来欢庆这复活的生命。
Lord, we thank you that we can celebrate the resurrected life together.
主，我们也愿意把从使徒保罗所听到的那纯正话语的规模，用在基督耶稣里的信心和爱心，常常守着。Lord,
we are willing to follow the pattern of words we heard from Apostle Paul and use it in our faith and love.
求主帮助我们，使我们能够理解神的话，能够记住神的话，也能够顺服你的话。We
pray for your help in understanding, memorizing, and following your words.
我们的祷告是奉靠耶稣基督宝贵的圣灵。We
pray this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
我们刚才提到保罗的境况呢，说他自己即将被处决，众叛亲离，然后我们却看不到他的沮丧和绝望，反而有一种极大的盼望在里面。So
we just mentioned Paul's surrounding. He's about to be executed. He experienced betrayal, but on him we cannot see any trace of complaint or hopelessness, but rather we see him in great hope.
这是为什么呢？ 实际上8节到9节呢，给了我们这样一个答案。
Why is that? Verse 8 and 9 tell us the answer.
8到9节说，你们要纪念耶稣基督乃是大卫的后裔，他从死里复活，正合乎我所传的福音。我为这福音受苦难，甚至被捆绑，像犯人一样。然而神的道却不被捆绑。Verse
8 and 9 says, remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel, for which I am suffering, bound with chains as a criminal, but the word of God is not bound.
所以这里面的逻辑关系是这样，9节说我受苦难，甚至被捆绑，像犯人一样，不是为别的。 是为什么呀? 为福音的缘。So
the logic in Paul's saying is like this. In verse 9, it says, I'm suffering and I'm even bound as criminal, not for anything else, but for the gospel. And what's the center of the gospel? It is Jesus' death and resurrection.
保罗讲的福音的核心的内容是什么呢? 就是8节所说的, 耶稣基督这位大卫的后裔,他从死里复活。
So verse 8 tells us the center of the gospel, which is Jesus Christ, the offspring of David. He died and rose again.
所以保罗说是因为这个原因使我充满喜乐。我受苦不是为别的,是为了福音的缘故,而福音的核心是基督的死和复活。So
Paul says, for this reason, I am filled with hope and joy. I suffer for the sake of the gospel, and the center of the gospel is Jesus' death and resurrection.
换句话说,是这位大卫的后裔,他复活的大能使我充满喜乐。
To change it in other words, it's this offspring of David, this great power of resurrection that made me filled with joy.
据说保罗在去世后几十年之内呢，教会里很快就充满了各种奇葩的教导。
It's said that within a few years after Paul's death, the church is being filled with weird and false teachings.
有人说耶稣并非大卫的后裔。
Some people say Jesus is not the offspring of David.
有人说耶稣并没有从死里复活。
Some people say Jesus did not rise from the dead.
所以人们开始讲述一位自己想象中的基督。
People began preaching about a Christ created by their own imagination.
所以保罗实际上是预计到这样的危险性，就在这里劝勉提摩太。
So Paul realized the great danger in these false beliefs, and right here he's reminding Timothy.
说你要记得圣经里是怎么教的，他是大卫的后裔，钉死在十字架上，三天以后从死里复活。你要讲这位复活的基督。
So he's asking him to go back to the teaching in the Bible that he is the offspring of David. He's been nailed to the cross, and 3 days later, he rises from the dead. So this is the Jesus you should preach about, this Jesus who raised from the dead.
其他的自己想象的基督都救不了你，只有这一位复活的基督才能救你。
All the other Christ created by your own imagination cannot save you. Only this living Jesus can save you.
所以对于保罗来说，基督的死和复活是非常重要的，它不仅仅是一个历史事件。
So to Paul, Jesus' death and resurrection is extremely important. It's not only a historical fact.
如果你相信基督的死和复活是一个历史事件，对，它的确是。
If you believe Jesus' death and resurrection as a historical fact, yes, indeed it is.
但只相信这个是不够的，这并不意味着你就是一个得救的人。
But if you only see it as a historical fact, it's not enough. This doesn't mean you have the saving faith.
有谁知道秦始皇是哪一年死的？
Does anyone know which year Emperor 秦始皇 died?
大概是公元前200年左右。
About 200 BC.
我不知道具体时间，但我知道他大概50岁就死了。
I don't know the exact time, but I know he died when he's only 50 years old.
所以要照这个年龄算的话，我还有一年就到头了。
And if you count like that, I only have 1 year left.
我的意思是说，他是哪年死的这件事可以是一个历史事实，但我知道这个历史事实，除了给我增加一点心理阴影之外，对我可以说毫无帮助，对不对？
So I'm trying to say is that, me knowing which year Emperor Qin Shi Huang died, can be a historical fact, but me knowing this historical fact, besides giving me some, mental worries, has no help to me.
所以他这个人跟你和我的生命没有任何关系。
So this person has no relations to your life and my life.
同样道理，如果你知道基督的死和复活这件事，虽然你知道秦始皇这件事有点用，但如果你只有这样一个概念性的认识，仍然是不够的，仍然不能改变你的生命。
So you knowing Jesus Christ's death and resurrection, even though it's more useful than you knowing who Emperor Qin Shi Huang is, but if it stops as a conceptual knowledge in your head, it's not enough. It's not enough to change your life.
因为那只是你头脑中的另一个知识点罢了。你的生命没有和基督的生命联合。
Because that's only a knowledge in your head. Your life is not united with Christ's life.
雅各书二章十九节说，你信神的存在吗？不错，魔鬼也信，但却是战兢。
James 2:19 says, you believe that God is one, you do well, even the demons believe and shudder.
魔鬼知道神的存在。
The devil knows God's existence.
他甚至也认识基督。
He even knows Jesus.
大家记得福音书中记载的那个在格拉森被鬼附的人，远远看见耶稣就喊，至高神的儿子，我与你有什么相干？我只是神恳求你，不要叫我受苦。
The Bible talks about a man who's been possessed by demons in Gerasene. He sees Jesus in the distance and shouts, what have you to do with me, son of the Most High God? I adjure you by God, do not torment.
所以魔鬼也相信神，也认识耶稣，但这种概念上的认识和相信，它不是一个得救的信心。
So the devil knows God and he knows Jesus, but this conceptual knowing is not the saving faith.
我想告诉大家，概念上的认识，知道基督的死和复活这个历史事实，和个人生命全然的投入去信靠基督是不一样的。
So I want to say conceptual knowing, knowing Jesus' death and resurrection as a historical fact, is completely different than dedicating your life into following Jesus.
真正得救的信心包括概念性的认识，但不止于此，还包括个人生命全然投入的去信靠和顺服基督。
The saving faith includes the conceptual knowledge, but it does not stop there.It also includes fully dedicating your life to trust and follow Jesus.
大家可能听到过这样一个故事，说有一个走高空钢丝的杂技演员，他技艺如此精湛，以至于他可以在高空没有任何保护的情况下推着一个小推车，在钢丝上穿越尼亚加拉大瀑布。
So, maybe you have heard the story before. It talks about high wire artist that he's so skilled that he's even able to push a wheelbarrow. Across the fall of Niagara.
而每次表演呢，大家都为之欢声雷动，为之惊叹。
Every time he performed, he's cheered by a large crowd.
所以有一次呢，他就在表演时候问大家。
There's one time before he performed, he asked his fans.
说大家相不相信，即便是我车里坐一个人，我也能带着他完成这个穿越。
Do you believe if I put a person into my wheelbarrow, I can still finish my performance?
所以大家纷纷激动地说，我相信你绝对可以做到。
They all shouted with excitement, saying that we believe you.
然后他又问说，谁愿意坐到我的小推车里来？我推着他，我们一起完成穿越。
And then he asked, is anyone willing to sit in my wheelbarrow so I can push you across?
马上你看我，我看你，都把手放下，谁也不敢让他推着自己。
Everyone lowered their hands and said nothing because no one is brave enough.
所以大家看出来了，什么是真的信心就显明出来，对吗？
So we can see what's the true faith this moment.
然后据说有一个小孩，他举手说，我敢。
There's a small child who raised his hand saying that.
然后这个杂技演员就推着这个小孩走钢丝，穿越了尼亚加拉大瀑布。
So this high wire artist pushed this child in his wheelbarrow across the Niagara Falls.
事后有人问这个孩子说，你怎么这么大胆，敢让他推着你呢？
Someone asked this child after the performance and asking him, why are you so brave?
这个孩子说，他是我爸。
This child said that he's my father.
所以我们看到这个孩子对这个杂技演员有一个全然投入信靠的心，对吗？
So we can see the complete trust this child has for his father.
我想告诉大家概念上的认识，你知道耶稣基督死和复活这个历史事实，和你个人生命全然投入去信靠基督是不一样。
So I want to repeat again that knowing Jesus Christ's death and resurrection as a historical truth is different than dedicating your life to believing Jesus.
真正得救的信心包括了概念性的认识，但不止于此，还包括个人生命全然投靠的去信靠和顺服基督。
True saving faith includes the conceptual knowledge, and it also includes fully dedicating your life to trust and follow him.
所以保罗在这里传达这样一个观点，就是耶稣基督的死和复活十分重要，它对我来说不仅仅是一个历史事件，而是一个你和你和我和每一个信徒的今天和我们今天的生命都息息相关的一个事实。
So the point that Paul is trying to make here is that Jesus' death and resurrection is extremely important. It's not only a historical fact, but it's a truth that is closely related to your life and my life and every believer's life here today.
所以复活不只是过去的一个事实，复活也是今天的一个事实。我们今天必须带着信靠的心参与到这个复活的生命当中来。
So resurrection is not only history, resurrection is reality, and today we must participate in his resurrection.
而凡是真正离弃罪、跟随主、信靠基督、与基督联合的人，我们今天都参与到这个复活的事实中。
And all those who turn away from sin and choose to follow and unite with Christ's life,all participate in the truth of resurrection.
所以保罗看自己就是这样一个有复活生命的人。
So Paul sees himself as a man with the resurrected life today.
所以弟兄姐妹，你知道吗？我们也是如此。我们今天就是一个有复活生命的人。
So do you know, my brothers and sisters in Christ, we are in the same way. We already have the resurrected life.
所以大家跟我一起说好吗？我们今天就是一个有复活生命的人。
Can we say it together? We already have the resurrected life today.
我们今天就是一个有复活生命的人。所以我们今天是灵里的复活，而且将来呢，我们的身体也会复活，进入神荣耀的同在。
So today we experience the spiritual resurrection, and in the future we'll experience the physical resurrection, and we'll enter the glory of God.
所以这是极其重要的信息。对于保罗来说，当他把这个复活的生命应用在自己的处境当中的时候，你发现他看待苦难的眼光就完全改变。
So this is extremely important information when Paul.Apply the concept of resurrection into his surrounding, we can see the way he views his suffering has completely changed.
他不仅充满了盼望，而且他甚至甘心情愿地为他人、为教会受苦。
He's not only filled with hope, but he's even willing to suffer for other believers' sake.
所以如果我们可以总结的话，我们今天可以说我们讲到的一个核心要点就是复活的大能改变保罗，使他甘愿为他人受苦。
So we can summarize the center of my sermon is that the great power of resurrection changed Paul and made him willing to suffer for others' sake.
九到十节说，我为这福音受苦难，甚至被捆绑，像犯人一样；而神的道却不被捆绑，所以我为选民凡事忍耐。
Chapter 9:10 said, verse 9 and 10 says, For which I'm suffering, bound with chains as a criminal. But the word of God is now bound. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect.
保罗说自己忍受这一切为了选民的缘故, 是为了教会的益处。
Paul says he endured everything for the sake of the elect, for the benefit of the church.
对于一个有复活生命的保罗来说, 在他看来, 教会的健康比自己肉体的安危更为重要。
To Paul, who is a person who already has the resurrected life, the church is more important than his physical well-being.
他甚至已经准备好离世, 但愿意借着自己的忍耐来兼顾信徒,使教会受益。
He's even ready to lead this world, but he's also willing to strengthen fellow believers and benefit the church with his endurance.
有人说基督徒为什么要受苦呢? 为什么保罗非得通过这种受苦的方式来使教会受益呢?
Some people ask, why does Christian have to suffer? Why does Paul has to suffer for the church to receive benefit?
首先,这是主的预言。
First of all, this is what God told us.
记得吗? 耶稣曾经教导门徒说, 你们要纪念我从前对你们所说的话。 仆人不能大于主人,他们若逼迫了我,也要逼迫你们。Jesus
once taught his disciples, saying that, Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecute me, they will also persecute you.
所以耶稣在这里教导这些跟随自己,这些与基督联合的人说,跟随基督,与基督联合的意思就是,发生在我身上的事,也会发生在你们这些跟随我的人身上。So
Jesus here is teaching those who follow him that the meaning of following Jesus and uniting with him is that whatever happens to him will also happen to those who follow.
所以基督徒受苦是主的预言。So
Christian suffering is what God told us.
另外圣经也告诉我们说,受苦对于基督徒的成长来说是非常必要的。And
the Bible also tells us suffering is necessary for spiritual growth.
正像孩子长大,他要经历各种挑战磨练,基督徒的成长也是如此。
It's like a child growing up, he needs to face all kinds of uncertainty and challenge is the same way our faith grows.
罗马书8章28节说,我们都晓得万事都互相效力,叫爱神的人得益处。
Romans 8:28 says, And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose.
有人说,哇,这是我最喜欢的经文。
Someone says, Wow, this is my favorite passage.
你们尽管折腾吧,神会让万事都互相效力,最后你会发现发财的是我。
Let all the other people do whatever they want. God will use everything for my good, and I'll be the one who ends up.
有人甚至梦见天堂，上帝赏赐给他名车豪宅，甚至还有美女如云。
Someone even dreamed of heaven that God reward him with good houses and car, and he was even surrounded by beautiful women.
美女如云彩般的围绕。He
says that he's been surrounded by a great cloud of beautiful women.
显然，这里的益处并不是指这些，因为这些。
Obviously, we know that the good God is referring to is not this. So God says his purpose is to benefit those who love him. What is this good that he's referring to?
这个益处就是我们的成长,越来越像基督,越来越圣洁,并最终得以进入神荣耀的同在。
This good is our spiritual growth, is that we are able to imitate Jesus and being sanctified and being able to enter the eternal glory with God.
那进入这个荣耀的途径是什么呢? 后面的经文也告诉我们说,神眷顾我们, 保证我们遭遇的一切, 包括苦难在内, 都会效力于我们最终的益处。
So how do we achieve this? The latter passage tells us that God bless us and he protect us from all that we encounter, including suffering, and all of these will serve the purpose for the good that we will receive.
29节到30节说, 因为他预先所知道的人就预先定下效法他儿子的模样, 使他儿子在许多弟兄中做长子, 预先定下的人又召他们来, 所招来的人又称他们为义, 所称为义的人又叫他们得荣耀。
Verse 29 and 30 says, For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified.
所以进入荣耀的路是这样的。
So here's the path to glory.
基督不仅为我们成就了这个救恩, 而且要像一个兄长一样,带着我们这些神的孩子们跟随他,我们会效法他。
So Jesus not only complete the salvation for us, and he's going to lead us as an older brother, lead the children of God, and we follow this older brother and imitate him.
所以效法他的意思就是说，我们和他一同谦卑受苦，也和他一同最终得荣耀。
We imitate his humbleness and suffering so that we may receive the glory.
正像十七节所说的，我们要和他一同受苦，也必和他一同得荣耀。
Like verse 17 that says, we suffer with him in order that we may also be glorified with him.
所以我们说保罗他自己理解受苦的这样一个必要性，他不仅是主的预言，在上帝一切美意的安排当中，受苦会帮助我们成长，可以效力于我们最终的益处。
So Paul understands the necessity of suffering. It's not only what God told us, it's also in God's amazing design that suffering can serve the purpose to help us receive the eternal glory of God.
不仅如此，我们看保罗在这里还说，我受苦是为选民凡事忍耐。
And on the, this, Paul also says that I suffer for the sake of the elect.
他认为呢，他的受苦可以作为一个见证，使得教会得建造，使神的百姓得益处。
The suffering can bear witness to fellow believers and to build God's church.
John Piper 牧师曾经写过一篇文章叫《不要浪费你的癌症》，大家有读过吗？
Pastor John Piper once wrote an article called Do Not Waste Your Cancer. Has anyone read this?
所以他不是说假如你得了癌症，你不要难过。他说假如你得了癌症，你不要浪费。
He's saying that if you had cancer, he's not asking you to not be sad about it, but he's asking you not to waste it.
我来给大家读几点，读几个要点，好吗？
Let me point out a couple highlights.
第一点，他说我们的患难和痛苦实际上预示着一个全新创造的来临。如果你不能够理解到这一点，你就会浪费你的癌症。
So he's saying that our suffering and pain actually foreshadows a new creation that's about to come. And if you cannot realize this, you are wasting your cancer.
他解释说，首先所有的苦难都是因为始祖堕落才有的。
He further explained this by saying that all suffering came from the fallen of Adam and Eve.
所以从这个意义上来说，所有的苦难都是一种审判。
So from this point of view, all suffering is judgment.
但对基督徒来说，因为基督已经替我们承担了这个审判，因而苦难对我们来说不再是审判，而是一个新生命来临前的阵痛，就像妈妈生产时的一个阵痛一样。
Since Christ has already taken our judgment for us, for Christians, the suffering to us is no longer judgment, but it's the pain we experience before the new life. It's like the labor pain the mother experienced before giving birth.
罗马书的八章二十二到二十三节说，我们以及这个整个被造界在等候被救赎，指望脱离败坏的辖制，得享神儿女自由的荣耀的时候，说一切受造之物一同叹息劳苦，直到如今。
Romans 8:22-23 says that for we know that the whole creation has been groaning together in the pains of childbirth until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves who have the first fruit of the spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for adoption as sons, the redemption of our bodies.
所以刚才读的这Jason 读的 ESV 英文版的这个就更清楚说，我们在新天新地来临之前所经历的这个叹息和劳苦。是那个英文是 pains of childbirth, 就像生产前的阵痛一样。
So again, the Bible describes the pains and suffering we experience as the pains of childbirth.
所以从信徒的角度来看呢，苦难不再是审判，而是生产时的阵痛，它预示着一个美好的生命即将来临。
So from a believer's point of view, the suffering is not a judgment anymore. It's the labor pain, and it foreshadows the new life that's about to come.
所以在阵痛中的妈妈不会忘记即将迎来一个极其美好的时刻，她不会忘记这个盼望。
So the mother who's in great suffering will not forget the amazing moment she is about to receive.
所以 Piper 说，如果你忽略这一点，你失去这个盼望，作为信徒，你就浪费了你的癌症。
So Pastor John Piper says that if you ignore this and you lose your hope, you're wasting your
第二点，他说，如果你认为你的癌症是个咒诅而不是礼物的话，你就浪费了你的癌症。
The second point he points out is that if you believe your cancer is a curse but not a gift, you are wasting your cancer.
Piper 说，虽然我们感受到痛苦，但不要忘了，它不是一个咒诅，因为基督已经替我们承担了一切的咒诅。
Pastor John Piper says that even though we feel tremendous pain, but do not forget it's not a curse, for Jesus has already taken all the curse away from us.
加拉太书的三章十三节说，基督既为我们成为咒诅，就救赎我们脱离律法的咒诅。
Galatians 3:13 says that Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us.
所以基督已经拿走了我们一切的咒诅，因而基督也不再是咒诅。
So Jesus has already taken all the curse away from us. So sickness is no longer a curse.
在神手中，疾病不再是惩罚我们的工具，而是净化和炼净我们，帮助我们成圣的工具。
Sickness is no longer a tool used by God to punish us, but is a tool used to purify us and sanctify us.
所以弟兄姐妹要记得，我们不在任何咒诅之下。Amen.
My brothers and sisters, remember you are no longer under any curse.
最后，张派伯牧师说，如果你没有好好利用你的癌症，让它成为基督的真实和荣耀的见证，你就是在浪费你的癌症。
Finally, Pastor John Piper says that if you did not use your cancer to bear witness for Christ's truthfulness and glory, you are wasting your cancer.
大家知道吗？基督早就预言了跟随他的人会受苦。
Jesus said long ago that those who follow him will be persecuted.
他说人要下手拘捕迫害你们，把你们交给会堂，下在监里，甚至押到君王和总督面前，但这却成为你们做见证的机会。
Jesus told us that, but before all this, they will lay their hands on you and persecute you and deliver you up to the synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before kings and governors for my name's sake. This will be your opportunity to bear witness.
这是路加福音21章的经文。
This is from Luke 21:12-13.
所以癌症也是如此。Piper 说，这是一个千载难逢的好机会，来见证基督是何等宝贵，来见证他比我们的生命更宝贵。
So Piper says cancer is like this as well. It's a wonderful opportunity to witness how precious Jesus is. He's more, even more precious than life itself.
所以希望张 Piper 牧师的这篇文章能够安慰到弟兄，进行平静。
So I hope this article can be a comfort.
弟兄姐妹，你如何看待自己的苦难？
How do you see your own sufferings?
或许你失去了工作，或者你被朋友背叛。
Maybe you lost your job or you experienced betrayal by a friend.
或者你因为信仰正在遭受逼迫，被人嘲笑。
Or maybe you are being mocked or persecuted because of your faith.
或许你在忍受疾病的痛苦。
And maybe you are bearing the pains of sickness.
你是充满抱怨呢，还是把这个当作一个荣耀主的机会？
Are you filled with complaint or do you see this as a chance to honor?
我们非常容易关注自己，对不对？
It's so easy for us to focus on ourselves.
当我们在苦难中的时候，我们的本能的倾向就是把目光全都集中在自己身上。
When we are in a pain, it's easy for us to put all the attention on ourselves.
有一个老牧师呢，他在临终前，年轻的同工们都去看他。
There's an old pastor before he passed away. The young people that he worked with came to visit.
当他清醒过来的时候，说的第一句话就是：“你们好吗？”你们的家人们都好吗？
When he's awakened and conscious, he asked the young people that visit him, asking them, "How are you and how are your families?"
所以他还是在关心大家。
So he's still concerned about those young.
几位同工根本就开不了口，就在那里默默流泪。
So all those young people cannot even speak a word, and they all.
就说在这个时候还在惦记我们。
Even at this point, he's still concerned about us.
所以这里呢，保罗说，复活的大能可以改变我们对苦难的看法。
So Paul says here that the great power of resurrection can change our views.
让我们知道，这个发生在我们生命中的苦难，不但可以见证主的荣耀，也可以使他人，使上帝的百姓受益。
And let us know that this suffering that happens in our life can not only bear witness to God's glory, and it can also benefit. Fellow believers.
所以我们说，我们的要点就是复活的大能改变保罗，使他甘愿为他人受苦。
So our key point again is the power of great resurrection, change Paul and make him willing to suffer.
不仅如此，保罗还强调说，他是为永恒的事受苦。
Not only this, Paul also mentions that he's suffering for eternal things.
所以十节说，所以我为选民凡事忍耐，叫他们可以得着那在基督耶稣里的救恩和永远的荣耀。
Verse 10 says, therefore endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation that's in Christ Jesus with eternal.
保罗看自己的苦难呢，不光是为选民今天和现世的益处，让他们得到一点点安慰。
So Paul sees the suffering not only for the worldly benefit he can offer to fellow believers.
更是为了上帝百姓永恒的益处，
It is also for their eternal benefit, so that they may receive the eternal glory in God.
所以正像我们刚才讲过的, 罗马书8章的经文,
so it's just like the passage in Romans 8 that we just talked about.
神使万事都互相效力, 叫爱神的人得益处, 这个益处是永恒的益处。
God works all things for the good of those who love him. This good is an eternal good, remember?
它不是腰缠万贯, 也不是名车, 豪宅。
It's not wealth or good houses or cars.
而是越来越像基督, 越来越圣洁, 最终我们会和基督一起进入神荣耀的同在。
It's being able to imitate Jesus and being sanctified and being able to enter the eternal glory.
而进入这样一个荣耀的途径是什么呢?
And how do we achieve this again?
就是基督像兄长一样, 带着我们这些神的孩子, 我们效法他, 和基督同坐后嗣, 我们和他一同受苦, 也必和他一同得荣耀。
As Jesus being like an older brother leading us, the children of God, and we imitate him, we serve as heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ. And when we suffer with him, we will also enter glory with him.
所以保罗说我受苦是为了这样一个目标。
So Paul says, I suffer for this goal.
为了上帝百姓永恒的益处, 以至于他们可以得享着完全的救恩, 进入永远的荣耀。
As for the eternal benefit of God's people, that they may receive the complete salvation and enter the eternal glory.
前年的时候,我去那个Starkville教会参加丹姐的葬礼,大家有人可能认识他。
2 years ago, I went to the church of Starkville to Sister Dan's funeral.
她临终前在视频里说的最多的一句话,大家还记得吗?
Do you remember what she said in the video before she passed away?
她说,我只有耶稣, 但那是我唯一想要的。
Says, I only have Jesus, but that's all I want.
我觉得这句话给了我极大的牧养。
I think this, her words bring me great comfort.
因为我就知道一个人在临终前会想些什么。
It made me realize what a person will think of before he leaves.
因为那个时候他肯定不会像我现在这样假装牧师好像自己还很属灵。
It's definitely not like me here up the stage pretending to be spiritual.
人到了那个时候很多内心的真实的想法都会不自觉地流露出来。
At that moment, some of your most inward deep thoughts will reveal itself.
你心里最惦记的是什么?
What is your biggest concern?
什么对你来说是最宝贵的?
What is most precious to you?
是什么带给你安慰?
What brings you the most comfort?
我想这些都会暴露无遗的。
I think all of these will be exposed at that moment.
你一定会抓住那一个对你最宝贵的东西。
And I think you will grab and hold on to what's most precious to you.
所以你看丹姐的话,她并不是给我们今天的生活带来什么好处。
So Sister Dan's word is not to bring any benefits for us here today, the earthly life.
她的话呢,给我们的信心带来极大的鼓励,她服侍到弟兄姐妹在永恒中的益处。
Her words give our faith great encouragement and serves for our eternal benefit.
所以我愿意安慰丹姐的话,也安慰到在座的每一个弟兄姐妹。
So I hope her words can be a comfort to you.
所以保罗说,我们的苦难可以服务于教会弟兄姐妹永恒的益处。
So Paul says our suffering can serve for the church brothers and sisters their eternal benefit.
因为我们身上可以见证什么是恩典中的长进和成圣。
Because on us we can witness what is the spiritual growth and sanctification in God's grace.
可以见证信心的果效。
We can witness the result of faith.
因而呢就可以成为教会弟兄姐妹的鼓励，帮助他们去追求那永远的益处。
Thus, we can become encouragement to other believers and help them pursue the eternal benefit.
后面的经文呢，保罗也给了提摩太一些劝勉。Finally,
Paul gives Timothy some reminder.
他告诉提摩太和以弗所教会的弟兄姐妹。He
encouraged the brothers and sisters in the church of Ephesus.
事实上也是告诉我们说，我保罗是如此为神的百姓忍耐，为教会永恒的益处劳碌和受苦。
It's also a reminder for us. Paul said that he endured so much for the sake of the elect, and he labored and suffered for the benefit, the eternal benefit of the church, and you should do the same as well.
11-13
Verse 11 to 13 says that the saying is trustworthy, for if we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we also reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself.
所以保罗劝勉提摩太这一段整个的主题，如果我们概括一下的话，就是我们要忠于基督，在苦难中依靠基督。
So the whole theme, if we summarize it, Paul's reminder to Timothy is that we shall remain loyal to Jesus and rely on him.
保罗在这里描绘了一幅以基督为中心，依靠基督得胜的画面。
So Paul here paints a picture of what it's like to have Jesus as the center and rely on him to.
弟兄姐妹，如果我让你想象一幅得胜的画面，你会想到什么？
So, if I let you imagine a picture of victory for Christians, what would you think?
我相信通过刚才的讲解，你肯定不再会说，是名车豪宅和美女如云了，对吗？
I hope from our previous message that you already know it's not wealth or cars or houses.
事实上呢，我也应该知道基督徒得胜的画面也不是一个自我刚强的画面。
Actually, we should know that a Christian being victorious is not a picture of self-strengthening or self-encouragement.
不是认为自己伟大、光荣、正确、所向披靡的一个画面。
Or thinking oneself as great or correct or invincible.
那么什么是基督徒得胜的画面呢？
So what is this picture of Christian?
其实保罗在这里就为我们画了一幅基督徒得胜的画面。
So Paul actually paints one here.
来看保罗。住在监狱里，被铁链捆锁，等待着最终被宣判死刑。
So Paul, living in prison, bound by chains, and is waiting to be put to death.
这就是一幅基督徒得胜的画面。
This is a picture of Christian being.
看上去有点惨，对不对？
It's kind of tragic, isn't it?
但大家知道吗？保罗正在经历真正的生命。
But you know, Paul is experiencing true life.
正在经历那一个复活的生命在他身上的果效。
Experiencing the resurrected life and its effect on this.
基督徒的得胜画面不是一个没有疾病、没有患难、没有挣扎。
A picture of Christian being victorious is not a picture without sickness or troubles or struggles.
而是在一切的疾病、患难、挣扎中的得胜。
But it's a victory in all these sufferings.
换句话说，这个得胜是患难也夺不走的得胜。
To change it in other words, this victory cannot be taken away by our troubles and sufferings.
十一节说，我们若与基督同死，也必与他同活。
Verse 11 says that if we have died with him, we'll also live with him.
实际上保罗就是在活出这句话。
So Paul is living out this verse.
他虽然在患难中，但是靠着基督，实际上他在庆祝这样一个复活的生命。
So even though he's in suffering, but with Jesus, he's actually celebrating this resurrected life.
十二节继续说，我们若能忍耐，也必和他一同作王。
Verse 12 says that if we endure, we will also reign with him.
保罗实际上在预备信徒要做好战斗的准备。
So Paul is actually preparing fellow believers to be ready for battle.
要持续相信基督，直到一天我们会和基督一同作王。
Until the day that we reign with him.
当然，后面呢，也给了我们一个警告。
Finally, we see a warning from Paul.
说我们若不认他，他也必不认我们。
That in verse 12 it says, if we deny him, he also will deny us.
这里的意思就是说，如果你非要从别处得救，你转而离开基督，不认基督，保罗说，他也必不认我。
This meaning that if you must seek salvation from elsewhere and you turn away from Jesus and deny him, Paul says that he will deny us as well.
因为只有他是道路、真理和生命。
Because only him is the way, the truth, the life.
所以我们总结一下今天的信息。
So I want to summarize the message.
保罗要告诉我们的是，因着基督复活的大能，患难就预示着将来我们最终的得胜。
So what Paul is trying to tell us is that Jesus' great power resurrection, because of Jesus' great power resurrection, our suffering, meaning the future victory that we will receive.
而和基督同死就意味着我们将来要和基督一同作王。
And dying with Jesus means that we will reign with him in the future.
因此患难可以用来装备我们来承受那将来永远的荣耀。
So our suffering can equip us so that we may take on the eternal glory.
也可以被上帝使用作为美好的见证鼓励其他信徒。
And it can also be used by God to bear wonderful witness to other fellow believers.
但最后呢我也想说一点。
Finally, I want to say this.
假如说你不是一个信靠基督的人。
if you are a person that does not rely on Jesus,
那就是另一回事。
Then it is a completely different matter.
对你来说，你的患难就是患难。
To you, your suffering is your suffering.
没有任何属灵的益处和价值。
There's no spiritual value or benefit.
只有复活的大能才能够赋予患难意义。
Only the power of resurrection can give our suffering a meaning.
在患难中，我们不仅可以带着信心安息在基督里。
In our suffering, not only can we rest in Jesus Christ with our faith,
也可以为主做见证，使上帝的百姓受益，使教会得建造。
We can also bear witness to the Lord to benefit His people and build His church.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，今天或许是近期我能够最后一次为大家讲道。
This is probably the last time I preach here in the near future.
我也愿意为大家祷告。
I'm willing to pray for.
求主应允我们，使我们今天在座的各位，没有一个人是离开的时候是带着一颗不信的心走的。
May God grant us so that no one leaves here with an unbelieving heart.
没有人是不肯相信和安息在基督里的。
No one is not unwilling to put their rest in Jesus Christ.
我们一起来祷告。
So let's pray together.
天父，我们感谢你。
Dear God, we thank you.
让我们在这一生当中能够相遇，也能够彼此的服侍。
That we may meet each other and serve together in this life.
我为每一位听到的弟兄姐妹祷告，求主应允我们。没有人离开的时候是带着一颗不信的心走的。
I pray for everyone listening. May God grant us that no one leaves with an unbelieving heart.
没有人是不肯相信和安息在基督里的。
No one's unwilling to put their rest in Jesus.
愿主复活的大能临到我们。
We ask that your power of resurrection come upon us.
借着我们的苦难，预备我们承受那永远的荣耀。
Change our views for suffering and prepare us to take on the eternal glory.
也帮助我们在苦难中能够成为教会和上帝百姓的祝福。
And may we be a blessing to your people and your church in our suffering.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.